Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, I want to cover all of the different ways that I know of forcing work to be done at compile time. And we're going to reference the work from another author as well in this. This episode of C++ Weekly is sponsored by me. Be sure to check out the video description for important links about upcoming events, sponsoring the channel with Patreon, buying copies of my best practices and puzzler books, and how to contact me if you are interested in on-site training or remote code reviews. Okay, so if you've been following along for the last few episodes, you are hopefully aware that simply making a function or a value const expr is not sufficient to actually force the compiler to do that work at compile time. There's no rule in the standard that says that value has to be calculated at compile time. Now, if we do make it static, then that forces the compiler to evaluate it at compile time, which is helpful, but now it has to be const. And maybe we don't want this to be const, we just want it to be a value that is initialized at compile time. So the next thing that the standard has given us is this const init. Now I'm getting a compile time error here because const init has to be static. So it's not a constant, but it is a static. And these things both fall under that constant initialization rule that we covered like two episodes ago. So make sure you watch that one when we're discussing the things about const expr that you probably have as a misconception. So the first one has to be const, the second one has to be static. If we do, let's make sure that we cover all of our bases here. So in the first case, it's not guaranteed and it has to be const. And in the second case, it has to be const and it has to be static. And in the third case here, it's not const, but it also still has to be static. So the next option is if we actually change this function to be const eval. Now all of these things are required to be calculated at compile time, but let's do this. Const eval functions must be passed a compile time constant. But that makes sense because we want this to be done at compile time. But it doesn't make sense for all functions to be const eval. Const expr is more versatile. So the next interesting way to force the compiler to give us a compile time value is one that I referenced indirectly in my previous video. So if I make this function called make compile time and I have a parameter in my template here and return this back, then I have forced the compiler to evaluate that it's at compile time because it must evaluate it at compile time to be a template parameter. Now this brings us to another option that I was made aware of from Andreas Fertig's blog. And Andreas runs through several of these options as well and has this function referred to as constant. And it's a const eval function that takes an auto parameter. And Andreas calls this as constant. And that works like we expect it to. It forces it at compile time because I'm passing it to a const eval function. So we were discussing this recently on Twitter, and there was some discussion here about movable and non-movable types between Daryl, myself, and Andreas. And I had this idea of making a thing that did an evaluation of a callable here, which led to this idea. And by the way, before I move on, I do suggest that you check out Andreas's book, Programming with C++ 20, Concepts, Coroutines, Ranges, and More, which Andreas has available on his website, on Amazon, and LeanPub. If you are interested in that. Okay, so let's get us back to this. The idea that I wanted to generalize is this thing called const eval invoke. And it is simply a wrapper around standard invoke that takes a callable and a set of parameters. But it's const eval, so it's going to force the compiler to evaluate this thing at compile time. Now, I do intend to make const eval invoke, as simple as it is, part of my utility library that I am currently putting together as a result of the little snippets from this channel. So be sure to check out my GitHub page if you are interested in that. But yeah, that is all of the ways that I know of to force the compiler to do something at compile time. And so it's a general solution here that is arguably not much different than Andreas's as constant, but perhaps you like one or the other better. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe.